Hello, Redlands readers. Let's take a look at some fun ways you can read books and create your own YouTube videos using your reading books. So as you know, you need to go to wevideo.com, should be familiar with that, and you click the login button, not sign up, but login. When you click the login button, you should have a welcome back. And you want to log in with Google. Warning, if you are not logged into your Chrome account, if you look up here, it's me, Dwayne. If you're not logged into your Chrome account, then when you log in with Google, it won't know who you are. So you will need to get into your Google Classroom Chrome account and you will click login with Google. So when you come to this slide or this page, this is your dashboard area. It automatically takes you to this dashboard. And this is where we're going to start our new video. So we want to click new video. And if it asks you which project you want to choose, you want to choose the project your teacher gave you. Most likely you will not see this when you start your video. Most of the time, when you click on new video, it will come right to this screen. First thing we do, we put our name on our paper. And you say, but Mr. Coles, we don't have paper. Well, you sort of do. Up here, this is where you put your name. See where it says my video? My video is a terrible name for your video. So I was given the title Ben and Sudi for the story I was supposed to read. And I like to put the title of the book and then my name. So there I am, Ben and Sudi by Dwayne. And take a look, there it is, Ben and Sudi by Dwayne. So once I have named my story, it's time for me to look for my book and start narrating my book. I do this by clicking on My Media up here near the top. And I go to click on the shared button. If it's closed, you'll see it look like this. If it's opened, you'll see a variety of shared folders. Because I'm in second grade, I want to find level readers 2 right here. I can also see it in a folder on the right, leveled readers second grade. So I can either click on this or I can double click the folder. When I look at the folders, there are 4 different shapes. There's circle readers, there's diamond readers, triangle readers, and square readers. In this case, my teacher assigned me Ben and Sudi, which is a circle reader book. So I double click circle reader, and now I look for Ben and Sudi. And there it is at the bottom. There's Ben and Sudi. So if I double click Ben and Sudi, I have all of the pages that I will find for Ben and Sudi. So now creating my video becomes pretty easy. I will start with Ben and Sudi 1 because that's the first picture that I want to use. And I will put that picture down into video 1. Notice on my preview screen, the title of the book shows up. Now maybe I want to narrate that. So I want to tell people, here's my title, here is who wrote it and who illustrated it. So I simply go to My Media, it's still there. And if I'm going to narrate just with my voice, I click Narrate. Click the Narrate button. And I'm going to click Preview while recording so I can see it. And here I go. Ben and Sudi by Pauline Cartwright, illustrated by Meredith Thomas, narrated by Dwayne Coles. When I'm finished, I click on the check button and it will save my video. After I've finished recording, you'll notice down in the corner or at the bottom of the screen, it says voiceover. And you see these little squiggly lines. That's my voice reading the story. Let's click on the preview to see what it sounds like.
Ben and Suti by Pauline Cartwright, illustrated by Meredith Thomas, narrated by Dwayne Coles.
You may notice that it looks like the picture is shorter than the narration. So I will take this picture, I will click on it, and on the left side, I will just drag it till it matches my audio. Now let's look at it.
Ben and Suti by Pauline Cartwright, illustrated by Meredith Thomas, narrated by Dwayne Coles.
So I finished the first page. Now I'm ready to go to Ben and Suti 2. Now this one was interesting because if I look at Ben and Suti 2, it basically tells me the same information that it did on the front page. So I'm going to skip page 2 because it really doesn't help me at all to use this page. I'm going to go ahead and go to the start of the story, which is Ben and Suti 3. I will grab Ben and Suti 3. I will then put it in video 1, and now I'm going to record the video with a narration and start the story. So click narrate. Remember, click preview while recording so I can see the book, and I will start. Oops. I will click the microphone button to start. The children stood in a row at the pet store. They looked at the kittens. Ben looked too. Stop it. Check mark. Notice this time in your video, you narrated this second piece, the second page. However, there is no voiceover. Well, you need to go to this scroll bar over to the right. Scroll down and you will see, oh, there it is. It's a voiceover too. I like to grab that voiceover and put it up next to voice one. So that's what I like to do. Again, you'll notice that my voiceover is longer than my book picture. So I want to stretch my book picture out. Let's see how my page looks now.
The children stood in a row at the pet store. They looked at the kittens. Ben looked too.
So I'm happy with that, and now I'm ready for the next page. Now I am ready to do the next page, which is Ben and Suti 4. I'll put Ben and Suti 4 down there, but this time, instead of narrating the book, I am going to record my webcam. If I record my webcam, my face will show up instead of just my voice. So click record. Click webcam and click next. When I look the way I want it to look, I look pretty good. I start recording. Ben wanted a kitten. Which kitten would Ben like most? You click the stop button when you're ready to end it. Click save. And you'll notice something strange happens. WeVideo puts my webcam after the picture. I don't want that. I want them to show up at the same time. So all I have to do is take my picture and put it over the book. But there's another problem.
Ben wanted a kitten. Which kitten would Ben like most?
My face is too big. So all I want to do is double click on my face. I will shrink it to fit somewhere. Maybe let's put it in the corner. That looks pretty good. I will save the changes, and once again, I want my book to be as long as my webcam video. Here's what it looks like if I use my webcam.
Ben wanted a kitten. Which kitten would Ben like most?
And there we go. I'm reading the book with my webcam. You might notice, say, hey, wait a minute. Where did my Ben and Sudi pages go for the book? Well, it's over here where it says Ben and Sudi. I just click on it, and there I go. I can get back to those pages. Now I'm ready for Ben and Sudi 5. Simple. I hope this has been helpful, and I look forward to seeing your books.